Hey my people, welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. Okay, I will try not to shout, but is that even possible in this Nigeria? Like, you guys are always making somebody crazy, especially the youth of this country. What is it? What is it? As Naira Marley done the EFCC net now, let us talk about it. What do you think is happening? So, what is happening now is EFCC alleged that Naira Marley and his accomplices conspired to use different Access Bank ATM cards to defraud their victims. You see all of you where they send these kind of messages. We have been trying to verify your account, and this is it. I cannot be verified. Please send your BVN number to social number. Is it all of you that send all those type of messages to people's phone? Your own turn is coming, because it will not only end with Naira Marley. Your own turn is coming. You better stop it. Also, you people that are always looking up to celebrities, their lifestyle, everything that they do, you copy. When they will catch you, I hope you have money to bail yourself. I hope you have money to bail yourself, because I am watching. I open TikTok, I see a lot of young boys like flaunting money up and down, wearing big chain on their neck. I'm like, when did you work for this? At your age, in a normal Nigerian setting, you're supposed to be in school under your parents. When did you work for this? When? What type of work are you doing that you don't have respect for your hard work? Because if you have respect for your hard work and you really worked so hard, that money will not be flying up and down. It is only money that you get carelessly from stealing, I'm sorry, from defrauding, I'm sorry. That is the only kind of money that you flaunt anywhere. Because if you know the meaning of sweating to make money, one naira will even be hard for you to bring out, because you sweated for it, you worked hard for it. It will be hard for you to come out. Look at what is happening to Naira Marley now. Now let's look at some of the things that has been alleged that he did. Now let's recall that Naira Marley was arrested, I think that was 2019, for this music Am I a Yahoo Boy. You know, he was arrested for that and dragged from court to court until he was bailed. And now this one. Now, some of the things that have been alleged that Naira Marley did is that the commission alleged that, you know, Fashola, that's his name, and his accomplice, which is one of them, his manager, conspired to use different Access Bank ATM card to defraud their victims. Okay, maybe when they send all those messages that they send, and they tell you send your BVN number or send your ATM card number so that we can help you to rectify your problem. You know, some of us are so ignorant, you know, and some of these old women and old men who don't understand all these electronic things, they'll just send immediately thinking it's their bank. My God. It alleged that the defendant used a bank credit card issued to another person in a bid to obtain fraudulent financial gains. The EFCC also said that the defendant possessed counterfeit credit cards belonging to different people with intent to defraud, which amounted to theft. This thing, I'm reading this thing from Premium Times. I'm reading from Premium Times that posted this, all these things that have been alleged on Naira Marley. The alleged offenses contravene the provision of the section 1, 23, blah, 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 of the Cyber Crime Prevention Act 2015. In 2020, the singer and his manager, Seyi Awonuga, were arraigned and sentenced by the Lagos police for violating the interstate travel ban during the COVID-19 travel restriction. The two accused persons pleaded guilty to the charge and were awarded. So, are they going to plead guilty to all these charges that have been alleged towards them? Like, this guy has been dragged from one place to another. Malians, what is happening? This guy has been dragged from one place. Let me just give a little advice to people. Because, you know, the young ones growing up think that everything is all about money, 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 money. Yes, we all need money. Money is important. But how did you get this money? How did you get this money? Did you have to defraud someone else to get this money? Did you have to deal with somebody else before you got this money? Did you have to stress somebody else before you got this money? There are so many fake lives that celebrities are living online and young people are emulating, living a fake life just to meet up to the standard that the celebrity lifestyle has placed for them. What would you gain to just chop this money for just like a year and you are caught? You are sentenced for life. Or you are even killed for it. What would you gain? Do you ever ask? This life is JJLU, step by step. Because of this, most of you are disrespecting your parents. Some of you are disrespecting people. You're stressing your mother. Do you ever think of what you're... Anyway, let me not even talk about mothers, because mothers have not even been doing their job. As far as I'm concerned, this world is getting worse. And that is because mothers have not been doing their work. Because if women as me have been doing our work as mothers as we're supposed to do, giving the advice we're supposed to do, we wouldn't have gotten here today. You can imagine a woman that would take his own son to go and hand over to some gangs to help train him for things. I mean, where are we getting with this? Like, we have forgotten that God exists. We have forgotten the word of God. We have forgotten that God says, I will bless you for your hard work. Not I will bless you for defrauding people. Not I will bless you for stealing. Because no matter how smart you think you are, defrauding people, let me tell you something. One day you're going to be caught. Because that blessing of yours didn't come from where it's supposed to come from. That money came from the wrong channel. So, Naira Marley's case, I don't know what is how guilty or how not guilty. We're still waiting to hear how guilty or how not guilty that he is. But I just hope that everything alleged might turn out to be wrong. But how can he even be wrong when EFCC is now involved? Y'all should be careful, honestly, because when I see young people like this, I'm like, oh my God, who informed them? Like, how have they been informed? Why do you think that this life should just end with just money, money, money? But you don't matter. It doesn't matter to you how you got that money. It doesn't matter to you. My dear, peace of mind. Have you ever experienced peace of mind before? If you have not experienced peace of mind before, that is why you're busy defrauding people. Because if you have experienced peace of mind before, all this one, you just take it step by step. You do it the right way. You do what you're supposed to do the right way. Get the right money. Peace of mind, because you need your peace of mind. You value your peace of mind. You want to sleep peacefully. You don't want sleeping and somebody somewhere you know, thinking about how he or she has been defrauded. You don't want to be sleeping and think of, oh, what will happen to me for this crime that I've committed. Let's be careful, honestly. Let's be careful. It will all end someday. Ask yourself, where am I going when it ends? Where am I going when it ends?